So once our maps are exported, let's import those in our engine. So we are starting with Marmoset toolbag. So I'm not going in depth about Unreal or Marmoset, like where is everything. All I'm talking about is material creation and a little bit about lights. All right, so this is Marmoset. Marmoset is one of the easiest software that you're gonna get into. It's quite like plug and play and quite easy. So first thing I'm gonna do is import our model. So to start with, let's start with the robot because that's what we did first. So that will be under CGMA, week 6, workflows, Marmoset and robo with objects, and that will be robo. Okay, these objects will be provided to you guys. So when you import your object, it divides that into texture set the same way which we did in Substance Painter, and we have our robo with all the objects that it has. Okay, let's minimize this. So I like to delete these guys because I like to start things from scratch, especially my materials. So let's click this guys, create two. So one will be robot, second one will be drops for the water drops. So let's drag this guy to our robo, and for the water drop, which will be this one, I'm gonna drag and drop water drop here. So let's go in and change our sky to color because I hate looking at a blurry sky. Let's pick in a different preset, maybe this one to start with. Okay, so right here we have our material section. So this is where your maps will go to support your materials. This is kind of like the channels inside Substance Painter, which is giving our maps to the shader and it's giving us our final look here. So it's quite easy. It's the easiest way to do it is just drag and drop your things, but let's not do that. So this is how we are gonna build material inside Marmoset. First thing, we are gonna apply a normal map. So in my work files, that will be Marmoset, robo. I have my low robot normal DirectX. Plug that guy in and that's a wrong material I was making. So robot, apply our normal map, and you will see our normal map looks weird. Reason being, we baked it in DirectX and Marmoset is OpenGL. It's quite easy to fix it. All you have to do is flip Y and we are done. Next up, we have our roughness map. So right now it's using a gloss map, but we are plugging in a roughness map. And if I make it invert, it's a actual roughness map. So yeah, that's what I mean. It was a bit idiotic to have a same map just inverted. So in order to use a roughness map, you have to invert it. Albedo will be our color. Pretty easy. For metallic, under reflectivity, you have to change from specular to metal. Click here and apply a metal map. Okay, quite easy. For emissive, you have to go to emissive, click here, make it emissive, plug in an emissive map, that will be right here. Alright, so pretty easy, its construction is quite easy, nothing biggie, and we have our material done. Okay, let's just go in, create a shadow catcher in my sky, let's add a light. You can create a light just by clicking on it, and you can just manually position it. Let's create a light so it creates shadows. And for my light, I'm gonna increase the width so I have softer shadows. Go to my view and disable show guides so I don't see the highlight in the ground. And I have my robot inside Marmoset. All right, pretty easy, nothing biggie. Let's do that for our another character the same way which we have done this time. These are the same objects that we imported in Substance Painter, and same way Substance Painter split that into texture sets, Marmoset is splitting that into materials. So I'm deleting this because I like to start things from scratch, as I said. 1, 2, 3. One will be torso, head, and legs. So you can directly apply it just by dragging and dropping to the place. So this will be head. This will be leg, this will be torso. Let's go to my sky, make it color because I hate this. Preset, let's pick in a simple one. All right, so to start with, we're going to start the same way. Let's start with the torso. Normal map, go to work files. That will be Marmoset, Chico, and yeah, this is a bit messy. So it's going to take me a while to figure out where everything is. So let's see. First up, we have torso normal map. So that will be torso normal map. It's completely wrong because we baked it down in DirectX. Flip Y to fix it, and we are done. For gloss, just get our roughness, invert it. For albedo, we need our color, which will be this one. For our specular, we don't need specular, we need metal. Make it metal, plug in metallic. For our emissive, go to emissive, click here and plug in emissive map. All right, I'm gonna make the HDRI completely one so it's not too dark. Or maybe just change in to a different one. Okay, so if you remember the last time we talked in the PBR section of me going dark with this project, I forgot to change it again for this one. So you can obviously see even the lights are quite bright. My material still looks a bit dark. So 0.35, this should have light it quite better, but it looks a bit darker. So that's why we try to keep it in a lighter side so it works well with every lighting situation. Like if I go to this one, it gets quite dark and I cannot figure out my material. Okay, so let me go in and do the same thing for everything. Okay, so everything is loaded in and my character is inside Marmoset. And I can go in and see it with the lights. One thing that we forgot to add in our robot and this one as well is an AO map. So once you export with those settings, you get an AO map by default. To plug in AO map, you have to come to your occlusion, make it occlusion, and under occlusion map, just plug in your AO for the channel for the element it belongs to. So we are on head right now. So for head AO, it's right here. And for our legs, let's add occlusion, which will be leg occlusion. Alright, so AO map is in, and that was the reason I kinda mentioned we don't like to multiply AO in our base color. Since we are splitting that in our shader, so the engine can calculate it itself without making it destructive. So once you bake your AO down in your base color, let's say you did that, it will be hard for different lights to make it look natural. So having a separate AO in our channel gives it more believable look with the lights. So let's go in, add a scene add object, shadow catcher to catch a shadow. Let's create a light, make it a bit brighter, increase the width so I have softer shadows, and on my sky let's make it a less intense so I can have a dramatic light or something. There we go, our character is right here. One thing which is quite important for Marmoset is a scene scale. So if I go to scene, show scale references, and make it centimeter, and make my show guides on. You see, before we had it on meters where our size is this. So in the 3D space inside Marmoset, this is what a 6 foot tall guy would have been like. And compared to that, our whole character is quite gigantic and the lights might not work right with this. So let's change it to centimeters and everything's gonna work fine. This is a really, really important thing, especially when you're shading a skin, because subsurface and GI works pretty dependent to the scene size. Alright, so once we have this done, let's go back to scene and disable show guards. Alright, so we have our character inside our engine. I can drag this light down to my sky. So when I shift, rotate my light, that point light also rotates with it. So I can finally see my model and make sure everything is working fine. Okay, that's how we export. That's how we import our materials inside Marmoset. Another nifty thing that we have is under render, we have our ambient occlusion, which is a scene ambient occlusion. So if you see the leg and the floor is getting more occluded, so it takes your object into account, not your textures. Then we have enable GI. GI is basically bounce back of light. It fakes that because in real-time engine we don't have ray tracing, which if I have to explain that, ray tracing is actual calculation of light, how light bounce back from each other. GI is just faking that, but it helps sell the believability of our character. Okay, so you can play with that to get different kind of result. So in general, that's how you create or import materials for Marmoset tool bag. It's quite easy, just drag and drop and try it out yourself and have fun.